Any mention of you being a white man?
Oh, yeah. I've actually gotten a lot of private messages that I remember one, my favorite one was, keep your male opinion out of it. Because I talked about hijab, and I thought that was hilarious. And then I was just like, I'm curious about this. And we went down the rabbit hole just a little bit. And it turned out that the person said, yes, you know, there are women in Islam that are oppressed because they couldn't deny things happening in Saudi Arabia or things happening in Pakistan or even certain parts of India or whatever. They couldn't deny that bad things were happening. They disagreed with because they were like a Muslim feminist. And I was like, yeah, so those are bad. And I'm talking about in at least one way, like, yeah, those things are bad. What they're doing is bad. And the person ends up saying, but that's not representative of Islam. It's not worth talking about because it's only the populations of this and this. I'm like, that's the population of the entire United States easily. Mm. Like, we're talking about like 300 million people are suffering at the hand of this. And you're like, ah, it's not worth talking about. No big deal.
Should men be part of the solution or keep their opinions out of it? Because you can't have both.
That's what I asked, and essentially it was, you can be part of the solution, but you can only play a support role. Yeah, you can't lead any part of the conversation.
But when it comes to the women's issues, especially with religion, it's really interesting because they talk about, you know, anytime you talk about hijab or burqa or whatever, people say that you're mansplaining, but that the entire religion is mansplaining. Like, these were concepts, these are practices that were invented by men. What you want to do is you want to accept the mansplaining of 7th century men in the Arabian desert, but you want to reject the mansplaining of 21st century men who are actually, many of them are sympathetic to feminism, and they were raised with the feminist revolution.
Secular Jihadists is an increasingly influential podcast with much of its growing audience in Muslim-majority countries, advocating for atheists, secularists, and enlightenment thinkers. We want to reach out to more people. If we reach 500 patrons, we will be able to translate our shows into Arabic, Urdu, Persian, Bengali, Malay, Turkish, and other languages in these countries. Help us get there at patreon.com/SJME.